Hello, Sagittarius. I'm having a very rough morning today trying to get my readings together. So, sorry. That's why I was laughing when I first started. Hello, 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 and welcome to all of the Sagittarians out there. This is Kelly from Deep Soul Tarot. Welcome to Deep Soul Tarot. This is Remy, my assistant and my little mascot, who is here to remind you to subscribe and join the tribe and also hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button. Thank you, Remy. Remy will be overseeing things. He's my moderator, if you will. We'll be doing your love reading for, I'm going to do these bi-weekly, at least for now. Schedule permitting, I'm going to be doing love readings now bi-weekly. So, just in case any of you cut out in the middle, do smash the like button if this ends up resonating and you like it. Or if you want to smash it now, that's fine with me. And I do encourage you to subscribe and join the tribe and hit that bell button for further notifications and comment. As I say in all the readings, put your birth date down there. You might find your twinsie. And the people that like and comment and interact with these readings are the ones that get their readings done first. And Sagittarians, thank you so much. You were the ones that I had a large amount of views and likes. So I'm doing yours first. See how that works? And share if you want to share with your fellow Sagittarians or friends or whatever. I would appreciate that. I'm also on Facebook and Instagram. I'm going to be going live very soon. I was going to go on Instagram, but you only have an hour on Instagram. I'm testing out Facebook and seeing how that's going to do. So go find me. I don't know how to set up a link. I'll try. I'm not sure if I know how to set up the link for that, but I'll try to put it below if I can. But I'm under Deep Soul Tarot. I'm pretty easy to find, I believe, on Facebook. I probably am the only one there. But I'm going to go live on there. And I was trying to figure out last night on my phone if I can save it and put it to YouTube. I think there's a way you can do that. I'm not sure. I was playing around last night. But definitely want to go live on Facebook, because then I looked it up and I might be able to do like readings there, you know, so I can go live there. I wanted to go live on YouTube, but I need 1,000 subscribers to do that on the phone. So, let's get rolling. This is a general message, general love message for April 1st through the 15th, 2020. So, it's a general reading. So, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. So, it may not resonate with you, or some of it may resonate, some of it might not. Just depends. Do check your, and I have a link below. You can click on it below and put in your birth date. And if you know your birth time, it's even better. You can get your rising sign. You can click on that, put in your birthday, and it gives you your whole chart. And I strongly recommend looking up your chart and knowing your placements, because for love, it's Venus, but your moon is about emotions, Mercury is about communication, Mars is how you handle altercations, and each placement in your chart has a specific part of your personality. So check your birth chart. So if this doesn't resonate, one of those may resonate more, or if this does resonate, those could give you more information. I'm just saying. I watch pretty much all my placements, and it's very informative, let me tell you. And these also, hello, any cross watchers that may be out there. The roles in this can be reversed. So if what's in the reading doesn't seem to resonate with you, it may resonate with more with your other person. So just keep that in mind. All right, so let's get rolling now. Okay. It's just kind of a weird, wonky day today, and I don't know, having a hard time getting out of bed. And I don't know. I know everyone's under quarantine and everyone's kind of stir crazy. I'm very much a recluse for the most part. I can be social, very social, but I'm much so it's not a big deal for me. I spend a lot of time alone. I like doing these readings. But you know, I thought the live chat thing is kind of cool, because if we're gonna be in quarantine, you know, we get socialized that way. And I was kind of looking forward to that. So I wanted to poo-poo on it, you know, last night and just see what I could do. But I share a room with somebody where I live. I'm on the West Coast. I'm in California. It's expensive here, so you basically have to share, you know, space in order to afford to live here. And I share a room with somebody. I mean, we actually share the room together, and so I can't really do any readings at night, and that's when I'm usually awake and more inclined to do readings. But anywho, let's get rolling. Okay, let me do a couple more shuffles here. Spirit, what do you have for our Sagittarians for the first half of April 2020? And Let me cut the deck, and then I will just specify. These readings are timeless, okay? So, this is based for the energies for April 1st through the 15th of 2020. But, if you happen to watch this video past that, that's okay. These are timeless. Energy, time is an illusion. Energy is fluid. So, some of this may have already happened to you. Some of this may be happening right now. Maybe none of this has happened yet. Maybe this is what's coming for your future. But it doesn't have to be within the first 2 weeks of April. But that's kind of the energies at that time and moving forward. Does that make sense? Okay. What do we have here? Wanting to be single. Sagittarians. Oh, wow. Oh, I'm sorry. No, that's not the right card. Lord have mercy. Hold on. Let me just get a sip of coffee. Nine of Pentacles look just like that. This is the Temperance card. I thought it was the Nine of Pentacles. It's a little dark in here because it's kind of overcast outside. I hope it's not too dark in the video. Needing some patience, needing some balance, Sagittarius. You're very passionate about something and emotional. And your thoughts are kind of all over the place regarding the situation. And you need to take some time to nurture yourself. All right, let's do this. Underneath all of that is the Queen of Swords. You need to step into your power here. And, you know, oh my gosh. It's Queen of Wands. Queen of Wands. Hold on just a second. I'm wearing glasses. They're a little smudgy. I could have done just fine, but maybe I should slap myself in the face. If you hear a loud slap, you'll know it's just me trying to wake myself up. Okay. Let's back up. Queen of Wands. Wands. So this could be you, Sagittarius, because Wands, fire sign. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So you could be dealing with a fire sign, but this could very well represent you, which I am feeling here that it does. And the Queen of Wands is all about stepping into, if I refer to he or she in the cards, it's not about your physical gender. It has to do with the energies of the cards, feminine and masculine energies. And so it doesn't matter what your gender is. You know, Remy, you want to take over here, please? I'm sorry. We all have masculine and feminine. I'll slow down. Feminine energy in us. I'll slow down for my benefit. Not for you guys. Me. I'll slow down so I can get this across the way it's supposed to get. I can't talk today. Okay. We all have feminine and masculine energies within us. We usually resonate with one more than the other. But your physical gender does not matter. Okay? Okay, I got that out. So, this is not only feminine energy, but for any of you who are going through a twin flame journey, like I am, 4 years into it now, the Queen of Wands can also represent the divine feminine. Okay? So, again, you could be a divine feminine regardless if you are male or female. You may resonate more with feminine energy as a male. You know, so it just depends. Just depends on, and just to be clear, I always state this, but because I just sort of think of it this way, but I guess I need to verbally maybe specify, because I have had a couple of people ask. These are not just for heterosexual relationships, just to make that clear. You could be in a same-sex relationship. It's love is love, whatever your situation is. Again, take it as it resonates. So the Queen of Wands is a very powerful person, very powerful energy. So it could be a twin flame connection, though, because here's the Four of Wands. And this is one of the twin flame cards. You know, it's 11-11. And with the Queen of Wands here, I'm thinking that it could be a twin flame connection. But it does not have to be. Some sort of soul connection. And let's go back with the general energies. So we do have, as I said, patience is needed here. and some sort of balance, Sagittarius. Because you're very passionate and very emotional about something. The emotion is fueling your passion. Okay, so there's a need for patience here. And a nurturing of yourself and or the situation, if you will. These readings are not for singles or couples in particular. And except for your sign. And these, there's a lot of information when you do the zodiac signs. But it could be your sun, rising, Venus, Mercury, Mars, Jupiter. Did I get them all? I think. But particularly Venus for love, besides your sun sign, and particularly moon. But, this is you, Sagittarius. Temperance is the Sagittarian card. So this is interesting. You have shown up big time in your reading, and you are like the main, this is the main event here. That's the main card. These are the supporting cards. So you are the main character in the story for sure here. Nurture yourself. And you know what? It's interesting that I thought that was the Nine of Pentacles, because I am still hearing that right now you want to be on your own. You want to be by yourself. Not that you don't want to be in a relationship, or if you are in a relationship, you just need some time out for something. Time out to think. Because something has fueled you emotionally, and you're very passionate about this. But you need a timeout. That's what I'm hearing. Need a timeout to think about things and to be patient. Because here's the Ace of Swords. And the Ace of Swords. It's about truth. It's about communication, truth, and thoughts. You want a new beginning. You either want a new beginning. If you are single, you want a new beginning and a new start in love. Maybe not at this very moment, but soon. I'm hearing that you want soon. Something has come to light to you. If you are in a relationship, you want some clarity. You want some clarity in a situation. Whatever your connection is, you want some clarity. You want to know the truth. And that's what I'm hearing. Very loudly. And I'm hearing the word clarity. A light is going to shine on a situation. Or you want to be enlightened about something or someone. And that's what I'm hearing. I don't know if that resonates for anybody. That's what I'm hearing. And you're going to take control of the situation. With the Emperor, you are definitely going to take control of the situation. But you do have to remember to have a little patience. And maybe spend some time alone to nurture this idea of yours. To nurture yourself so you don't let the emotions and the passion cloud your judgment. If that makes sense. If that makes any sense. All right. Let's get to some parts of the story here for you, Sagittarius. Okay, we're going to start with the wheel. Something's happened. Something has happened. I'm hearing that you've, like I said, you've seen the light. I'm hearing like an aha moment. You've realized something. You've realized you either want more out of the relationship that you are in, or you've realized that you're ready for new love. And the Wheel of Fortune is a lesson learned. You've learned a very valuable lesson. I'm hearing learned a lot about yourself. But learned a valuable lesson, and interestingly enough here, And if the Empress comes out, I'm going to freak out. If you look at the picture in the Nine of Cups, and, I mean, it's kind of an obvious picture, but then in the Wheel of Fortune, too. Now, generally with these two separately, it's about nurturing yourself. And I mean, when you see that depiction, but there are two of them here. And if the Empress comes out, she's the same way, I believe. Holding the belly. And this may, I'm hearing this, this may only be for a very small number of you, maybe just one of you. Somebody has found out they're pregnant. Somebody's found out they're pregnant. And you're very emotional about it. Happy about it. It's almost mixed emotions. I'm hearing mixed emotions. You're happy about it, but you're also very emotional because I don't think this was necessarily planned that way. That's what I'm hearing. And to me, this is almost like a positive test. The test, you checked. You thought you were, you checked, and it's a positive test. And now you have to figure out, take control of the situation here and figure, and this was fated, you know? Wow. You know, especially with these economic times, this is going to be, not that it's going to be difficult. It is going to be difficult. It is in general when you have a baby, when you're pregnant, you know, but, oh, there's our doggy. But you have to take control of the situation and figure out now, from this point on, how you're going to deal with this situation. Maybe you haven't told the daddy yet, and or the other person. Again, if you're in a same-sex relationship. So the wheel. There's a lesson that's been learned here, and this is coupled with, let's see, Page of Swords. There you go, the truth again. The Page of Swords is all about... The Page of Swords is a very inquisitive energy, likes to get down to the root of things. I'm hearing very, very strongly that, crap, again, I'm hearing you, because the page is a messenger, and you've been to the doctor, and the doctor has confirmed you, yes, you are pregnant. I keep hearing that. I mean, you know, take that if it does resonate with you. If you're suspicious that you might be, you might want to have that checked. Okay. But putting that aside, because obviously that's not for everybody. That's just for very specific people. So you have the Wheel of Fortune and the Page of Swords. Not only have you learned a very valuable lesson, you found out something about your person, whether you're in a relationship or not, that you did not know. Now, to some of you, that may sound like deceit. That may sound like, holy crap, are they cheating? And again, this is a general reading, so, you know, don't panic here. I do not hear, unless something comes out beyond this, like the Seven of Swords, or anything that's the devil, I do not see any negative connotations here for the Page of Swords. You know, I'm hearing, Sagittarians, you just want to get down to the root of things. You just want to get down to the, you know, are we or aren't we going to be in a relationship? Are we or are we in a serious, committed relationship? Depending on if you aren't in a relationship, you know, are we? Is this going to happen? Or... if you are in a relationship, where are we going with this? Do you or don't you want to be in a relationship? You just want some clarity, you know, to be able to move forward. So right now you're taking some time off because, again, the Nine of Cups, very emotional. You're very emotional about this. And again, passionate about it, where you're like, I'm not going to let this go. I want to know. You're going to tell me. You are going to tell me. You're going to tell your person. Or you're going to maybe boldly go up to whomever you're into and say, hey, what is this that we're, if you're seeing somebody, what is this that we're doing? You know, am I just a friend with benefits? Is this just a, you know, a flock, buddy type thing? Well, let's move on here and see what we have. We have the Three of Wands. I am hearing very, very strongly that you're going to take command of the situation, Sagittarius. You know, I'm hearing you don't like to fuck around when it comes to these kind of things. You don't like to fuck around in general. You want people to be upfront and honest with you. And somebody is either skirting the issue or not being forthright with you. I'm not saying they're lying, but they're trying to avoid answering you directly. Does that make sense? And so, what I'm hearing with here with the Three of Wands, got the Three of Wands, is you're going to have to choose a path. That's the Two of Wands, choosing a path of either, or maybe you're going to give this person an option. Either you tell me now what we've got going here or what you want, or it's just not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. I'm not going to fuck around here. You know, I'm not going to play around. I knew somebody, and she was a Sagittarius too. Melody. She's not watching, I'm sure. She's not into this. She's very, very conservative religious. She's from Georgia, from the South. Very conservative. Would not be, you know, happy about this kind of thing. So I doubt she's ever, would ever watch this. But anyways, she was, they were from Georgia. And, I guess this is a saying in the South, or at least in Georgia. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. She used to say that all the time, and I used to love it. And that's what I'm hearing here, Sagittarius. And it's just funny because she's a Sagittarius. Ain't nobody got time for that. You know, I ain't got time for this. What are you doing? Are we something or are we not? That's all I want to know. And then this, the Three of Wands, is choosing your path and going forward and just waiting to, the Three of Wands is about waiting for your ships to come in. But I'm hearing with the Three of Wands is that you already know the two paths you can take. I mean, you're giving an option, and I can either stay with you. If you want to be in a relationship, I will stay with you. You don't want to, I'll take the other path, and I'll wait for somebody else to come in. I'll wait for my ships to come in. I'll wait for the right person for me. I'm not going to waste my time with somebody else. The Nine of Wands, definitely. Oh, definitely. Oh, Sagittarius, you are so close to giving up on this person. You're ready to give up. That's what being alone is. You want some clarity. You are... It's like you've separated yourself from this person. Because it's like, I don't want to fuck around anymore. I don't want to play around anymore. What are we doing here? You know? Maybe you're serious about the person, and maybe the person's acting like they're not as serious about you. And now you just want clarity. What is this? Because I want to know. Because I ain't going to waste time with you. I ain't going to waste any more time with you. Are we doing this or aren't we? You know? Maybe they're flaky and they go back and forth. Let me see if I can see any particular signs in here. No, just you. Oh, excuse me. Emperor. Could be an Aries. Another fire sign. I mean, you've got other signs here. You know, of air signs. You have a lot of fire here. Water signs, air, but that doesn't, I usually go by court cards or high, major arcana. So you have your own card, Sagittarius, you have Aries so far. That's what you have, but it doesn't have to be sign specific, but it could be that because they've shown up in the reading. Okay, let's see, moving on. All right. So the Nine of Wands is, I mean, this indirectly, this has hurt you, you know? So it's almost like it's a kind of a warlike attitude, so to speak, that it's like, I'm not playing around here, you know? I'm hearing that you've been wounded. Wounded in battle is what I'm hearing, but wounded by this. Because maybe you thought this person was more invested than they actually seem to be. Let's move on and see if I can get anything else. Oh, there's the sun. Oh, Sagittarius. Oh, Sagittarius. Guess what? Guess what? The universe has different plans for you. Mm-hmm. Just briefly underneath that, Five of Swords. You're ready to go to battle. You are ready to go to battle. underneath that is interesting. It's the Two of Cups. And it's like, you know what? If you don't want to be with me, I'll find someone who will. You know that? You don't want to be with me, I'll find someone who will. Let me move this. You're ready to go to battle. And you're ready for... You're ready to move on. Here's the Queen of Cups here. Okay, with the Sun card, and I'm sorry, I don't know if I showed you, the Sun card and the High Priestess. I'm trying to feel the energy of the High Priestess here. With the Sun card, it's interesting, you have the Sun and the Moon, you know? It's like, to me, it's like night and day. Sun, Moon. Sometimes this person, or let's put it this way, sometimes you are happy with this person. You get along great with this person. You love this person. You have a good time together. But they're too mysterious. They're too mysterious. And I don't think you like that. You like people to be upfront and forthright. You like to know what you're getting into. You don't want to waste any freaking time with someone who is not going to commit to you. And that's what I'm hearing here. So again, you're going to take charge of this. And I'm hearing that there could very well be an argument at some point here. Some sort of battle. And the Five of Swords is about loss, so I'm not saying that's going to happen that way, because these don't predict, nor do they tell you what to do. They just guide you. You know, y'all have free will. You know you, and you know your person. So you decide what is appropriate for you, because I'm not hearing anything terrible. I'm not feeling any bad energies like cheating, lying, deceiving in a sense that they're seeing other people, or leading some other double life or whatever. I'm just hearing that they're being a little deceptive as far as not telling you truly how they feel or truly what they want. And I'm hearing that they may not want the committed relationship that you do. But this is the time for you now. You're going to step into your power. Step into your power and really think about what it is you want. You know? You're going in the right direction here. But, so Sagittarians, I'm hearing it's all about wanting a commitment. Because you're like, what I'm hearing here is basically what you're going to say to this person is, listen, you know, I'm not going to fight with you. Oh, come on. Oh, I have to let that go. I'm sorry. I'm going to stop for just a minute because I know that's annoying. I'm going to let them leave a voicemail. If I decline the call, I hear people tell me that it cuts them off. And this is I have an appointment. Because I don't know about the rest of y'all, but in California, everything is shut down. We're on mandatory, and I call it lockdown. Got into a debate the other day. Someone thought, it's not lockdown. What is your Texas? She's in the same area. Like, whatever. What the fuck? It's mandatory. Shelter in place. We have to stay home unless it's extremely necessary. Like going out for necessary items. Can't find any toilet paper, but whatever. And we're going to a doctor's appointment. But most of the doctors, unless you have an appointment that is a serious situation, they're doing it over the phone. So I have an appointment coming up on the 20th. Oh, tomorrow. No, what's today? I don't know. Whenever it is. Anyway, they're going to do it over the phone, so they're probably sending me a reminder or something. So I need them to send a voicemail. So I'm sorry. Let's continue. Sorry for the interruption, Sagittarius. That's the bad thing about doing this on your phone. it works fine otherwise, but there's certain stipulations and things that happen that you can't really control when you do it on your phone. Okay, voicemail. If I'd had the volume up, you would have heard AC/DC Thunderstruck, and then Korn Got the Life. Just saying. okay. So, you want to be in a committed relationship, and basically your stance is, if you don't want to be with me, I will take the loss, you know, that's fine, I'll move on, We're apparently not on the same page, and I want to be in a relationship. I want to be with somebody who wants the same things that I do, you know? And if this person really does care for you, even if they don't want to be in a relationship, you know, they would have the courtesy enough to tell somebody, you know? So, you know, I had that experience with someone once. My twin, actually. We had a little discussion about, you know, I was interested in being with him. I really was, because we had such a great connection. And, you know, at that time, and he told me, he could have lied. He could have easily lied. We don't live in the same area. He could have easily lied and said, no, yeah, sure, we can be together. And then he could have cheated on me, because I would have never known, you know. Because he has a bunch of friends, including female friends and what have you. And so I would have never known. But he told me, well, at this time, I'm not in a good place and blah, blah, blah. And he was right in a way. He really was. So I gave him credit for telling me, at least telling me. And we're still friends. We're still friends. We're not in contact right now, but I still love him to death. Well, you know, whatever. But he'll always be dear to my heart and a friend to me. So I miss him. You know, we don't hang out. But anyways, so we're going to get some messages from the universe. Okay, spirits, can you please give the Sagittarians out here whatever messages the universe may have for the Sagittarians in addition to this? There we go. See what we have here. We have Five of Cups and the Queen of Cups. Alrighty, Sagittarians. Let's see what we have in the bottom of the deck. There's that damn Page of Swords again. Yep, 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 yep. You want clarity and you want it now. Oh boy. Okay, I'll get to that in a minute. I'll get to the bottom of the deck. I'll continue with that here in a minute. Yeah. Sagittarius. I am hearing quite strongly, because the Five of Cups is about regret. What I'm hearing with this card is, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this anymore. And it hurts you. It hurts you to have to do that, because you do care about this person. You do love this person. Not saying they don't care about you. I don't know about love, because I don't know, you know, how long you've been together and what have you. If you are together, you know, maybe you've been hanging out and now you want to get into a relationship. You've really gotten in, you know, you're into this person, and they're not as into you as far as relationship. Oh, I never said this was an exclusive relationship type thing. You know what I mean? So this is extremely hurtful for you. And there we go again with holding the belly. Holy crap. You got the Nine of Cups and the Wheel. And I don't know, man. You might want to check. For those of you out there that are females, you might want to check about the pregnancy thing. Just saying. This is a side note. But that could, basically what that shows, though, in the cards, when you see that, is asking you to nurture yourself. You know, that's feminine energy. You know, you've, this is the Queen of Cups, and that's a Cancer card, but, so you may be dealing with Cancer, perchance, I don't know. Doesn't have to be, though, again. And the Sun card is Leo, just saying. Do we have any other ones? No. Okay, it's basically telling you to nurture yourself like you would a child. Just be very, very kind to yourself. Be gentle with yourself, because this is probably a very emotional situation. I know Sagittarians like to be tough on the outside. You know, I know, because that one I told you, ain't got time for that. Nobody ain't got time for that. She was very stoic, you know. You could tell when she wasn't in her best place. And she was just the type of person that did not want you to, I'm not going to say coddle her, but she wanted to be strong. She wanted to perceive herself as strong. And so what I just would do was just give her a hug and just let her know, I'm there. I'm here for you if you need me. So I know you Sagittarians, you know, you try to act tough on the outside, but I know you got a heart. You really do. And, genuinely. And so when you're hurt, it's hard to, almost acknowledge. I'm not sure. I mean, I don't know Sagittarians well enough. I don't know if Sagittarians perceive that maybe as a weakness, you know, being emotional, especially to externally, not internally. You know, they may be acknowledge it on their own, but as far as, so make sure you take some time to nurture yourself, be kind to yourself, because this is a hard situation, you know, and, you know, you have the right to know where you stand with a person and a connection. And so, but this is very, very difficult for you. This is a difficult, but you're like, I can't deal with this empty relationship, this empty connection anymore. But guess what, Sagittarian? Just because you see the three spill cups, you got two cups back here. So there's new love that could very well be coming in, and soon, you know. Take your time, but there's the Page of Swords, and then I was going to say underneath is the Six of Swords. You want clarity, and you're moving on. I think you're going to be moving on from this person. What's under that? Yeah. Yep. Absolutely, Sagittarian. You are going to approach this person and talk to your person, and you're going to say, if you haven't already, you're going to say to them, listen, I want to know. I want to know what this is. You know, what the F is this? What are we doing here? You know, just tell me. If you're not into this, like I am, or if you're not into this, I'll move on. I'm fine. And of course, internally, you're hurt, but you're going to say, you know, fine, I'm fine. I'll be fine. And you will be fine. But still, it's still emotional. It's emotional for anybody that has to do that. But you're going to move away from that. And you're going to, and this is calmly, you're going to take those thoughts. You're going to take that information. You're going to go off by yourself. Hermit. That's a Virgo card, just in case. Could be dealing with a Virgo. But I think you're going to go off and you're going to spend some time alone. And you're going to work on yourself. And then after that, you can have... Yeah, there you go. There's a brand new beginning, the Fool. You'll be fine. You will be fine. With the Fool under there, you'll be fine. You'll be back to your happy-go-lucky, you know, love and life Sagittarians. And you'll be ready for love. So this is going to be a tough process, but... yeah, I'm hearing that you want the truth. So, all right, Sagittarius. Let's get an animal message card for you, shall we? Let's see what message the universe has as far as animal message. What do you have for the Sagittarians? And then I'm going to pull an Oracle of the Fairies card, which are kind of lighthearted. Oh, crap. I hate when that fucking happens. Oh, my big head's probably going to get in the way now.
Hi, Sagittarius.
Okay, you got... Ah! Chameleon. Conceal ambition with patience until it is time to make your move. Patience again. I'm hearing that you want to move forward. You know, Sagittarius, I am hearing that you really, really want to be in a relationship. You want someone to be your partner in crime. You want someone... to build a life with, basically, for a lot of you. I mean, this may not resonate with all of you, you know, but, and I know you're independent people, you Sagittarians, so it's conceal the ambition with patience. Be patient with yourself, but be patient with the situation. I am hearing that you could very well be moving on from this person. I am hearing that this person is not on the same page as you are, unfortunately. But maybe that's a good thing. You know, it's all about divine timing and, you know, whether or not you're in a twin flame. I know twin flame connections, you talk about divine timing. But as far as, let me see what's on the bottom here too. Distracted by all the noises around me. I don't know if you can hear it. In spite of your independence, you want somebody who is going to be in a relationship with you. Is going to be basically, hopefully, a partner for life. And so you want to just kind of move forward. You want to deal with this and move on. But you have to kind of heal yourself. You know, many times in life, it's all about go, go, go. And I know Sagittarians like to keep, you know, move forward. But you're going to have a little patience with yourself in the situation in order to find the right person. You don't want to go out there haphazardly and meet people and then meet the wrong person again and go through this all over again. Does that make sense? So, on the bottom of the deck, you have the deer. The deer is a very peaceful creature. Gentle and peaceful creature. Take note of the messages in whispers and secrets. Take note of the messages in whispers and secrets adrift on the breeze. Well, if you can go outside in the breeze. We're allowed to go outdoors. We're allowed to go for walks. It's a 6 feet distance, but you can't be out for long periods of time. You can go out, get your exercise, go in. You know, we do have cops that are patrolling in this area, and, I mean, they are trying to get people to stay indoors, but if you're going to, you know, if you're going to go against that, you could very well get a misdemeanor charge. Just saying. But, so, you know, just listen to the universe. Feel the energies of the moon. If you're into, you know, be in tune with, that's what it means by spending time as a hermit alone. Just be in tune with your thoughts, your feelings, the messages, you know, take this time if you are in quarantine. I think we're all pretty much in quarantine, but take this time to really think about when you do enter into another relationship, when you meet another person, which I think you will. I am hearing you will. With this two of cups, you're definitely going to meet somebody, all right? And could very well get into a relationship. Take your time. Take your time, Sagittarius, all right? Let's get a fairy card, and let's just see. What advice can you give our Sagittarians out there, Spirit, in regards to their love situation? Wisdom. Have you ever been told that you're wise beyond your years? Now is the time to call upon your inner fairy wisdom to help you with the challenge. Call upon your fairy wisdom. And that's the hermit. You have the wisdom within. Again, I said you're very wise people. You know, you're very independent and wise people. You have the wisdom within. And I think you know that. You're very strong individuals for sure. But it's still emotionally, it's still emotional for you. You know, so I know y'all like to be strong. I understand. I'm a Cancer cusp of Leo, so I'm water and fire. So I have the hard shell. I protect my inner very, very diligently. And I also have pride for being Leo. And I have an Aries moon, so there you go, man. I have a lot of fire in my chart. Leo and Aries, and I have air. So my sun sign is really only my watery sign. But it's hard because, you know, being a Cancer, I'm very emotional. And as you Sagittarians are, you're emotional on the inside. But hell, if I want to let people know that I'm hurt as I am. You know, I walk around very stoic. And in my mind, I'm thinking, you fuck with me again, you better watch out. Better watch out. you know. And that's, I don't know if that's the fire side. I have no idea. I don't know. And I don't know. Maybe that's cancers too. Well, crabs will pinch you. But Sagittarians, you're very strong-willed and you're very tough and diligent. But, you know, be gentle with yourself. You know, you don't have to show your emotions to the world. Nobody has to know that. But just be gentle with yourself. But I do feel that, again, call upon spirit, call upon the universe, call upon your inner fairy. Wisdom to help you through this challenge. And you will be able to move forward. But I'm hearing this is all about getting some clarity right now or in the future. Maybe you're still in the relationship and you're contemplating this and you just want some damn clarity and you're going to ask for it. Okay, Sagittarians, that is what I have for you. I hope this helped you in some way. Again, if you like this and it resonated, please smash that like button. It gives me a little feedback. It helps the channel. And then I also will pay attention when it comes to the mid-month readings. You know, if you watch, hit the like button. Definitely people who comment, those who interact, are the ones that are going to get their readings first. That's the only way I can gauge it. You know, I was trying to figure out a way to do it, and I think that's fair, because why would I want to do someone else's reading sign if they're not really watching the videos, right? Maybe they're not into live stuff. I don't know. But anyways, do subscribe and join the tribe if you haven't already. And hit the bell icon for further notifications so you'll know when your bi-weekly comes up. And I will be doing a twin flame reading on Friday for those of you who are in... I'll be doing a twin flame reading. Or it may already be up. I don't know. I don't know who's going to be first. We'll see. But the twin flame reading will be up. You'll be notified if you subscribe. So, share and comment. Please do comment. And join me on Facebook. Come follow me on Facebook and Instagram. And we can go live. And then I can do, you know, like a live reading. We can chat and do a live reading in there in the room and have some fun. Especially in these quarantine times, you know. So, you take care, Sagittarians. And you'll be fine. You get through this and you'll be fine. There's nothing wrong with wanting clarity in a relationship. And if that is not working for you, that wasn't the person for you. Just keep that in mind. You know, as hard as it may be internally, again, nobody has to know how you're feeling, but be gentle with yourself and you will find your love. So, you know, if this may not be your person. And when you get through this and work through this, then you can open up your heart chakra again and you can welcome in the person who could very well be the one for you. Thank you, Sagittarians. I love you. Mwah. Peace out.